When building a modular synth, polyphony refers to how many notes can be sounded at the same time. Let's take a look at how to take control of the polyphony in a SynthEdit project. Now that we have control over the length of the notes being played, we need to get control over the synth's polyphony. Polyphony refers to the maximum number of notes that can be played at any one time. Right now, our synth can only play one note at a time, which means it's monophonic. I have a little external keyboard I'm going to use as a controller, so you can see what I mean. To use an external keyboard, just click on MIDI, and select MIDI in, and add it to the project, outside of the synth's container. Connect the MIDI data plug to the MIDI in on the MIDI to CV module. Last, go up to Edit and select Preferences. Under MIDI in, select your controller, in my case, the Axiom 25. Now I can play with my Axiom instead of just clicking the notes on the keyboard module with the mouse. If I try to play two notes at the same time, only one note sounds, since the synth is currently monophonic. If I play one note and press another key, while still holding the first note, you can hear the first note cut out, letting the second note play. What we want to do is be able to play multiple notes at the same time, so we can play chords. The first thing we need to do is move this MIDI to CV module inside of the container. I'll cut and paste the MIDI to CV module. Then connect the gate plug to the ADSR, and the pitch plug to the oscillator, and then delete the old patch cords. Now, connect the MIDI data plug on the MIDI in module to the spare plug on the container, and connect that to the MIDI in on the MIDI to CV. In older versions of SynthEdit, we used to be able to select the MIDI to CV module and change its polyphony properties. But in SynthEdit 1.2, we do things a little differently. Now, we use the Polyphony Control module. Click on Special, and choose Polyphony Control, and add it inside of the container. The Polyphony Control module doesn't need to be hooked up to any part of the synth we've created, just placed inside the container. With the Polyphony Control module inside the container, multiple voices can be played simultaneously. But if we click on the Polyphony Control module, there are no properties to be set, which means we can't just set the number of notes allowed without adding another module. This time, we want the List Entry 3 module under Subcontrols. Click to place it inside the container, and connect the Polyphony plug on the Polyphony Control module to the Choice plug on the List Entry module. Then, connect Item List to Item List. Now, if you click on the box here, you can set the maximum number of notes that can be played simultaneously. If I set polyphony to 2, and I play 3 notes, you can hear the bottom note being cut off as the third note begins to sound. For each note that sounds, or each voice, SynthEdit recreates this container in a separate instance. The more of these voices, the more memory your synth will use. The maximum amount of voices allowed is 128, but most computers aren't going to be able to handle 128 voices playing at one time. A more reasonable amount is somewhere between 8 and 32 voices. Of course, if you don't need that many, don't use them. A monophonic bass plugin only needs one voice. Having more would just be redundant. The next thing I'd like to discuss is the next pin down on the Polyphony Control module, Polyphony Reserve. I'll add another List Entry 3 module, and connect Polyphony Reserve to Choice. And then Item List to Item List. When we set the polyphony, SynthEdit allows that number of voices to be created. In this example, 2 voices. However, if we press a third key, the first note ends. When the first note has ended, it takes time for that voice to fade to silence. It's not really noticeable by ear. It happens over a matter of milliseconds. But those milliseconds will cause the next voice to trigger later than you want. SynthEdit uses polyphony reserve as a series of spare voices, so that when you play more notes than allowed by the polyphony setting, the next note will be immediately triggered. This allows the first note to fade out naturally, and the new note to sound as soon as the key is pressed. Just like with polyphony, only set this as high as you need it, and never set it higher than the value under polyphony. If you have two voices, there would never be any reason to have three reserve voices. By using the Polyphony Control module, we are able to gain control over how many voices our synth is able to sound. This is an important ability to have, since certain instruments behave in certain ways. A piano has one string for each note that can be played, whereas a bass guitar has four strings, but many notes that can be played on each string. Playing notes up and down the E string of a bass will sound different than playing those same notes up and down a piano. The piano is polyphonic, while playing on one string of a bass would be monophonic. All of these characteristics can be recreated using the polyphony control. Thanks for watching. If you found this content helpful, please consider supporting me on Patreon. Comment, like, and share this video, and subscribe for more tutorials. See you next time.